Madame Bata Shoe Museum. We founding children, wonderful awards such as Order of Canada, Woman of the Year, of course, and Shoe Person of the Year, bien sûr. Alors, s'il vous plaît, accueillez Madame Sonja Bata to say a few words. Thank you.
Very sentimental, and I will tell you about Roger Vivier when I first met him. I got married in the late 1940s, and you remember that the Dior came out with a new look, and naturally after the war, women wanted to be women again. They were fed up with the war years, with austerity, where you know, everything was very military and big shoulders and boring shoes, you didn't care if you look. And then came Dior with his new look, the tiny waist, the flaring skirt, busting up, and people fell like women again. And this was fantastic. And there the shoes were missing. And Roger Vivier complimented Dior really with the highest stiletto heels, which during the war years, though he had, really didn't exist. The stiletto heels and the pointy toe, and it was the look of femininity. And also his materials, they were so sumptuous. And after not having had any materials, suddenly to have this wonderful silk and to have the craftsmanship of this outstanding individual. So he was my hero. And I, at that time, I had married a shoemaker and I wanted to learn all about shoemaking in the world. So I was very keen and ambitious to learn from people. And Roger Vivier had a special way of making glass. And I see here, Mr. Misani here, so you know all about it. For him, a last was a piece of sculpture. It was not just a piece of wood to pull over or the inside of the shoe on it. But he studied this piece of sculpture as if he was a great artist, taking off a little bit here and a little bit there, and creating something which was totally new. It wasn't necessarily the most comfortable shoes. But it was an item of beauty. And his longing for doing something which was perfect. Every detail you see on the Vivier shoes, the details are so perfect, and the way how the implementation was done, it's true only few people could afford it because they were expensive. But it really changed the Western fashion world. In fact, I almost would compare it to something which happened during the French Revolution, and going back now to 1792. Beautifully fished tonight. I'm so glad you are here and I hope you enjoy the evening. Thank you.